Greetings world. We are anonymous. We do not forgive, we do not forget. Expect us. Spiritual care is every person's right, it addresses the needs of patients, friends, and family members when they're seeking hope, meaning, comfort and strength, especially during life crises, but provincial budget cuts eliminated funding for spiritual care in Saskatoon's hospitals, faith communities were left to pick up the slack. The lack of spiritual care personnel in local hospitals was never more evident than following the Humboldt Broncos bus disaster, when Code Orange was called at RUH, there was no spiritual care to alert, no clergy was notified, boys died in the ER that night with no minister or priest present to offer comfort and prayers, families had no spiritual support. That lack underscored the importance of SCOCS, the Spiritual Care Advisory Council of Saskatoon, which was formed following the budget cuts. The council is composed of representatives from Christian denominations plus Muslims, Hindus, and Baha'is. Its purpose is to advocate for spiritual care in hospitals, to explore ways to compensate for the current loss, and to be a support team for churches and spiritual care volunteers who must fill the gap. The withdrawal of funding eliminated two paid spiritual care positions from City Hospital and three from Royal University Hospital. Two Aboriginal spiritual care people were absorbed by the representative workforce and continue to receive provincial funding. The situation is a bit different at St. Paul's Hospital, which is a faith-based institution. The founding Grey Nuns left a legacy to ensure spiritual care would be ongoing at St. Paul's. It is now supported by SPH Foundation. SCOCS meets monthly to share updates and brainstorm ideas. One of the big things they discuss is ways to lobby the government and the health region to bring back funding for spiritual care in hospitals and keep spiritual care footings in place. The changing policy on clergy lists is always part of the discussion. In the past, patients admitted to hospital were asked their denominational or faith preference, lists were compiled and forwarded to appropriate spiritual care workers, but starting in September 2018 patients will no longer be asked their religious preference, doing so is now deemed a breach of privacy. Instead, anyone wanting a visit from a spiritual care volunteer must give informed consent, in effect, they must request a visit. SCOCS is printing cards for patients with information on spiritual care services in Saskatoon hospitals. The cards will be displayed in each room at every bed, they'll be laminated so they can be wiped clean and kept germ-free. They encourage people who have a personal faith or belong to a particular congregation or faith group to inform their spiritual leader or faith representative about their admission to hospital. The leaders of faith tradition are welcome at the hospital and encouraged to visit and conduct activities such as spiritual counseling and prayer. SCOCS members stress that a person doesn't have to be religious to benefit from spiritual care. A spiritual care provider can listen to concerns and provide support. Spiritual care isn't only for people who are dying, it's for anyone seeking personal growth or anyone who needs help coping with change, illness, or loss. Hospitals aren't here just to mend broken bones, they need to deal with the spiritual aspect as well. They want to partner with the health system to provide holistic care, especially end-of-life care. Lots of patients are dealing with end-of-life issues and everyone has questions. They need to talk, they need support. The Spiritual Care Advisory Council of Saskatoon invites participation in exploring avenues of action. Many denominations have written letters to government lobbying for a reinstatement of support for spiritual care in hospitals. SCOCS is planning to hold a reception at the legislature this fall to present the case personally to members of the Legislative Assembly. A court hearing has been rescheduled for August 15 to provide victims of the Humboldt Broncos bus crash with $50,000 each from a massive fundraising campaign. The Humboldt Broncos Memorial Fund Incorporated will ask the Saskatchewan Court of Queen's Bench to approve the interim payment to the 13 survivors and the families of the 16 people who died after the April 6 crash. There are affidavit materials filed that establish that certain families of persons who were traveling on the bus at the time of the accident have suffered financial hardship and require some relief against that, and that's the purpose of the distribution, said a lawyer who represents the fund. A GoFundMe campaign was created immediately after the crash and received $15.2 million in donations from all over the world. Saskatchewan has legislation known as the Informal Public Appeals Act, which outlines a court-supervised process to support the distribution of crowdfunding donations. The hearing on how to distribute the money, which was initially set for August 13, was rescheduled at the request of the court. The lawyer says he will also ask the court to approve a committee made up of retired judges, chairman of the company that owns the Winnipeg Jets, Olympic gold medalist Haley Wickenheiser, Dr. Peter Spafford, who's in charge of head and neck surgery at the University of Saskatchewan's College of Medicine, and Kevin Cameron, executive director of the Canadian Centre for Threat Assessment and Trauma Response. That committee would prepare a report with recommendations to the Memorial Fund Board on how to distribute the rest of the money. The objective would be to have the recommendations come back within 60 days after the August 15th court hearing and then see the matter in court shortly thereafter for a final disposition. The court documents state the nonprofit group has received free professional services from its law firm, bank, and accountants. GoFundMe has deducted roughly $483,000 from the money raised to cover 2.9% payment processing fees, and an additional $49,000 is being held back by GoFundMe in a temporary reserve in case any donors challenge their contribution. We are anonymous. We do not forgive, we do not forget. Expect us.